Hi, and welcome to this video. We are Bert and Evelien from Nubera.
We both enjoyed reading the book The Phoenix Project by Jean Kim. For those of you who didn't read the book, it is a story about an IT project that goes horribly wrong. But for many of us working in IT, it is so recognizable. The main character of the book, Bill Palmer, developed a new way of working in order to meet the business requirements for his IT department. The book is fiction and fun to read, and there's a lot to learn from it. We want to share our findings with you.
Although the book covers many important concepts, we would like to focus in this video on the concept of the three ways. More specifically, we will demo you how Dome is using these concepts later on in this video. The phrase the three ways is used to describe the underlying principles of the DevOps movement. The DevOps movement is sometimes viewed as being conflicting with traditional IT management, sitting alongside Lean and Agile as a different way of dealing with software delivery and IT management. We at Nubera see on the other end a great opportunity using these concepts and applying the three-way thinking in our way of working so that we can support DevOps. So let's get into it. Let's briefly describe the three ways. The first way focuses on maximizing flow of work from left to right, meaning starting from a business ID, going through development and IT operations to end up with the user. While going through this flow, we should focus on limiting work in progress and removing constraints along the way. Evelien, can you show us how we do this in the Dome framework?
Yes, so we use Jira for our Scrum board. We have sprints of 2 weeks long. So in those 2 weeks, we try to move as many user stories as possible from left to right, so from to do to done. We also try to minimize the scope of one user story. For example, if you look at this epic automated Kubernetes installation, you can see that we divide the big tasks in multiple smaller user stories.
All right. So the second way focuses more on increasing the feedback loop from right to left. The focus is not only on getting feedback, but also on how fast we can get that feedback in order to make the necessary corrections and improvements quickly. Evelien, can you give us some examples on how we use this concept and how it works for us to safely work with complex systems?
So the first example is pipelining. We use GitLab pipelines. This is an example of our Ansible role, which we use to install GitLab. As you can see, a pipeline consists of multiple stages. The first stage is the prepare stage. The second stage is the test stage. This is a very important step. We check if the Docker file is written correctly, and we use Molecule to test our code in Kubernetes and OpenShift. If all the tests are passed, we build the image and we push it to the image repository. The second example is how we manage images. This is an example of our Packer Ansible image. As you can see, we have a lot of documentation about this image. If we go to repository and tags, you can see that we tag this image with version 1. So if we add something to this image or we change something, we give it a new version. This way we make sure that we don't break other components using this image. We also use review checklists. This is an example of a checklist we use for Ansible code. So we make sure that the molecule tests are not skipped. We check if we use yes or no instead of true or false in our YAML files. And we check if there are no secrets pushed to Git.
All right. So the third way is all about developing and creating a culture of continuous experimentation and learning. Key is to understand that the way to mastery is through practice and repetition. One example of this concept is that we have a bi-weekly demo moment where everybody has the opportunity to show the work that they've been working on. That being said, we hope you enjoyed watching this video. Please feel free to leave your comments and feedback below and make sure to subscribe so you don't miss out on our next videos. Goodbye.